Hi, there is another one of my favorite type of events in King of Avalon, and it was about time because I was really losing a bit of interest the past couple of days. It has the name heat wave, which is I don't know how it is in the rest of the world, but here in the Netherlands it is a very suitable name. Let's put it like that. It's been very warm. That also, I guess, took away my energy a bit to play the game. But this is of course definitely interesting. Let me join that rally because I'm almost have my stamina bar full. For me, yeah, what is one of the things that this wasn't this rally that got cancelled? Shouldn't be the case, but. Lately, I had been always joining setting barb rallies, joining with my farm accounts, going past all my farm accounts to donate to Alliance Tech. I really felt that I didn't have the energy anymore to do that. Don't know whether that energy will come back when the weather is a bit more decent, but let's see. Anyway, for now, this event that did give me a bit more energy. For the free shop, as usual, not very interesting things. We have some lake gravel and enchanted mist, and can get 50 eternal flame. I will definitely try to be active enough to grab those three, and perhaps the speed ups and the steel. Those are really the only important things. Normally, I'm playing active enough to really grab all the rewards. I don't know if I get, if I will be that active this time around. But normally, when you're active playing, it shouldn't be an issue at all. The juice shop, it's a bit of the usual item. Some things a bit cheaper than they used to be. So we have some added amber statue material. Crystallized gem is new because that wasn't available last time. It was still gemstone essence, but that was not in the shop last time. We have some sun hearts. Tears of ascension was not in the shop last time. Glory fragment, elementite, I think is a bit cheaper. Just like meteorite iron, we have silver obsidian, emblem essence. These are the more interesting, or also quite interesting things. I guess everything is interesting. The Genesis statue arcana, I'm not, yeah, I don't really like that we can only get half a statue. That's not enough for me. Same with the Sanguine arcana, also only, no, this might only, I don't know how much you need, actually 100 or 200. Haven't checked yet, but for sure it's not going to be enough. Apocalyptic statue arcana, I already have all of those. Water Drake doesn't seem so expensive, and it is going to take a very long time to get them from the doing the portal, so might purchase this. Dream Arcana is a bit seems a bit silly to put in the shop, as it is very easy to get these days with the by hosting some ceremonies, holding some ceremonies, hosting. Advanced Dream Arcana. It's a bit cheaper, but still only 50, which is not nice. Definitely want to get another Torrent hero weapon. Destruction Ingot is also very slow via all the rallies. In my eyes, very slow, so you get it some from barb rallies. You get a bit from Kingdom versus Kingdom and from the Ultimate Alliance Conquest, but yeah, for me that's going very slow, so I might very well purchase one. But yeah, lately what I was realizing, thinking, I mean, I knew it before, but I mean, buying all these kind of things, it's kind of a one-time benefit. If you increase your, and eventually you will get better statues, better gemstones, better everything, and then spending things on this has been just a temporary benefit, while buying emblem essence, silver obsidian, meteorite iron, and so on and so on and so on. That will kind of have a permanent benefit, it seems at the moment, because even if you have higher level items, then you still need the same ingredients. So I'm now more inclined than before to focus on those ingredients. Anyway, I'm not going to focus too much yet on what I want to buy. Let's first look at the scoring some points, and then we can see later. Sorry, that's the wrong one. Haven't done the cocktail night at all. That's one of the things that it's probably, I mean, it's stupid because it is easily watched, but I just haven't played a lot at all. Okay, the summer heat wave is giving some points for increasing the highest equipment score. So I'm going to do that first. First have to, let's equip. I've again looked at the points, the high score and the current score. My current score is a bit below my my high score, but I have quite some ingredients, so I should be able to do quite well. I'm going to upgrade two of my destruction pieces from plus one to plus two. A bit inclined to take those two that have a bowman attack. Quite a lot of adamantite. Steel is the major issue, it seems, although maybe meteorite iron not too far behind. What are the benefits actually? I mean, it's not that huge, but it is nice. So let's see. So that already got me all rewards. I could, in theory, maybe try to do a bit more, but that doesn't make sense at this moment. So using Philosopher's Stones, I actually have quite some. I think I have more than 1,200, but I think I will stick to doing 800. Maybe there will be another one. And normally, if you look at, okay, spending an extra 400 gives you 150, but the first 800 is going to give me more than 300. So actually, yeah, maybe I can better hold on to the rest a bit and spend some more. And besides that, ultimately, I can also show you what I want to achieve. I mean, what I'm really would like, and what I believe is quite valuable for solo attacking, is to have this Undying Oath to to have that ultimately to level 5, and especially those last two levels, especially the last level, that is giving quite a big increase. This one also already quite okay. At the higher the level, the more increase. And I would really like, now I'm going plan to do this one, and then I really hope to plan to focus and then get the, probably not next time yet, but after a while make the final jump. And that is giving quite a nice extra increment in the percentage. While looking at this, I realized when I was collecting some data for my website, I removed the High Steward so that I could have the accurate requirements. So, okay, going to research that one, the Undying Oath. Actually was thinking, should I switch to, but I shouldn't, I shouldn't switch to my research gear. doesn't make much sense. Because the other event is to use research speedups. Jump in another rally, sorry about that. Okay. And maybe I should just, besides the gear, also set my talents to war. Could I speed it up from there? I don't have huge amounts of, not huge, I have a very small amount of research speedups, but I do have a large amount of regular speedups. I think I also got some quite some extra from this recent update where they replaced the individual rural buildings with just one of them. And that they compensated me with quite some speedups, luckily not construction speedups. Maybe first look at the event. I can claim some things again. So that's nice. So for the research speedups, not sure where I'm, how far I'm going. Might not go to the last stage again. That is an increase of 50,000 minutes, and we just get an additional 100 for the first two. Yeah, we get much more, or yeah, significantly more. But yeah, I'm going to do the old trick for the dragon spirit. It's a bit annoying. Maybe I'm just going to do 1,000 of these to not have to speed it up with hours. Did I write down somewhere? So if I do this, let's do this three times. And then see where we got. I haven't maxed out all research, but close to. At least, except for the advanced research that requires the, or superior research, or whatever they call it, that requires the philosopher's stones. Always annoying this red. So that is then still quite a lot. 10,000, 12,000, 11,400. It's like how many hours, 200 hours, bit less. But I'm a bit, it's too warm for me to make, oh, that was the wrong one, too warm for me to make an accurate. I still have quite some iron. This will overshoot it a bit if my calculations are correctly, and that is fine. I'll let it running in case my calculations were not correct. No, they were correct. So that gives me quite some points. I'm going to cancel this. Okay, well, I think that was already it for the first day of the event. I'm not sure whether I'm going to make videos of every day, but I'm quite happy with this first day. It's a good good start, 1200 credits. Now let's see what we can do in the remainder of the week. I'm already for sure very happy with this torrent. That is just going to be quite a big improvement. Okay, that was it. Thanks for watching this video, and if you have any comments or any questions, that's always much appreciated.